Harry and Daniel. This is Bernie.
All right, guys, you okay?
We're here today to talk about Liverpool FC Youth in Focus. So, as you know, Bernie, last year not only did we win one big shiny thing with big ears, we also won another trophy too, which was...
the FA Youth Cup.
So, we wanted to talk a little bit about the players who were instrumental within that season, within the season last year, and talk a little bit about which players, given in the current squad, could potentially break through, want to look out for, and obviously even developing in the future.
Yeah, because as we've both talked about already and in the past, we don't think he's going to go out there and get a big marquee signing, so it's going to be a lot of the kids coming through, hopefully.
It's a distinct possibility. I mean, you look at Tottenham and, you know, there's pros and cons to what Tottenham have done over the last couple of years, but there's no denying that when you look at the finish in the seasons gone, they've finished stronger and got better as a team. That might change for them now as it's probably, there's a bit of a transition, but I think Klopp has probably got the same sort of idea in terms of keeping his group small, keeping the mentality and the culture right, and having players which have always been involved in that is what's going to feed into our future.
Well, it's keeping them hungry as well. You've got a squad of 25 professionals, maybe 30. You've got the 25 kids, keeping them hungry, giving them a chance.
Absolutely.
So we've got the good basis of a squad, and we've got to not fill it or pan it out, but we've got to give the kids a chance to come through. So there's a couple that we want to talk about tonight, isn't
it? That's exactly right, yeah, and it leads into our transfer policy too, because, you know, how are we attracting the youth? Well, we're attracting the youth because they know that there's an avenue into the first team through us. Mm-hmm. You know, Trent Alexander-Arnold's probably a classic example of that, really. We'll talk about Trent a bit further.
So...
given the gaps in the squad, obviously Moreno's left, I want to talk a little bit about Adam Lewis. Adam Lewis was obviously present in the USA squad.
Was at the pre-season last year?
At the pre-season last year, played a couple of games out there in Boston and did really, really well. I remember Klopp talking about him and Nat Phillips in particular, glowing references. And obviously there's a vacancy in the squad at left-back position.
There is now, yeah, definitely.
Yeah, and he's obviously a Liverpool lad, born and bred, played consistently last year, got a number of games, and is someone to watch out for in the future at 19 years old.
And with him being a local lad, it's not more pressure, but it's you can see they want it more, you know what I mean, and coming through. So, yeah, he sounds a good one, and from what we've been told, he has got a chance of getting some time, especially in the pre-season.
Well, that's right, and Klopp will obviously take a close look at them, because any player that comes in, if we were to go out and buy a left-back right now, it's probably going to cost us anywhere between 10 and 20 million.
Yeah.
It's going to be a player who's not going to play regularly unless it's Robertson, he's going to be like the goalkeeper reserve, he's not going to get many games.
Yeah.
And he's got to be comfortable with that, and he's also probably got to add value and not cause unrest. So is it better to give a young player a chance? Is it better to give someone like Adam Lewis a chance? Other than that, there's also another lad there called Larucci, who's also a left-back who's recently come into the team.
Yeah, he's had glowing reviews as well, so yeah, there's a few of them. It's a hard job that Klopp's got, because again, it won't be him. Obviously, he'll be getting from Neil Critchley coming through from the academy and all the others, the other coaches there. It's how you pick. Once you get that chance, you've got to take it, haven't you? And they're going to get a chance, and let's hope that they take it.
Yeah, absolutely. And there's definitely a gap in that left back position in the squad. So, you know, if they go into the pre-season, obviously there's some big games coming up in that friendly schedule. Mm-hmm. After we play the local teams, there's a couple of glamour fixtures, not to mention a little Super Cup and Community Shield too.
The first three games are 45 minutes, and it's two teams, isn't it?
That's right,
two blocks of 11. So they're going to get a chance there, and then so... with the new guy that we've bought, Sepp
Vandenberg.
Yep. Okay, again, there was a good point put across. Why has he come to Liverpool when he could have went to maybe Ajax to fill in for De Ligt, or De Ligt, whatever you want to call him? When he goes, eventually gets where he's going. But obviously, Klopp's most probably had a word with him or whatever, that he's going to come in and be in the under-23s.
Yep.
But, you know, again, we're getting told, we're hearing different things, that no, he's going to go into the first team setup.
Yeah, that clear path of development again. And I know there's been a bit of a clamour to look at another centre back, but you know, obviously we've got Gomez there, and then we brought in another young lad who potentially has a pathway to the team. Mm-hmm. You know, Matip is, you know, probably in his prime, but Lovrencic, as we talked about before, is 30 years old now. There's going to be a space opening up in there for a player, for a centre-back, and there's a chance there for one or two players to stake the claim. So moving further up the pitch, I believe there's two gentlemen in particular we want to talk about who were instrumental in that cup win.
We've got Bobby Duncan and we've got Paul, I hope I say it right, Gletzel and Bobby have both scored the same goals, haven't they? 23. They played roughly the same type of games all season. Bobby Duncan's well known to be Stephen Gerrard's cousin.
That's right, yeah.
They're banging them in like there's no tomorrow. Gletzel is German parents but born in Liverpool. So again, they know what it's all about, and people are raving about maybe we need to go out and buy a striker. We've got Brewster who's been told he's coming through.
That's right.
And then you've got these two guys coming through and they're only 18 right. years of age, what I mean?
Yeah.
So it's the potential there to bring them in and blood them in their friendlies at the beginning of the pre-season and then be on the outskirts of the first team. But the only problem you've got now is that if someone sees a gap into the team, they'll take it.
Yep.
They might feel it might be blocked, so hopefully we can keep hold of them and we can keep them entertained.
Right.
So, if you look at the outgoings with Camacho, he didn't want to, he was given a pathway, but
didn't want to take it, that's right.
There you go.
Yeah, Bobby Duncan is a bit of a fox in the box. He reminds me of a real traditional English like striker throwback to strikers probably long gone.
Yeah.
Now he comes alive when the ball comes in the box, and then Glatzel's always buzzing around on the outskirts, looking to basically make one-twos, combinations, get into the box and get on the end of return passes.
Yeah.
They've been very competitive. Obviously, they've both been chasing each other's goal tallies, but also at the same time, they formed a great team, which is great for us.
Well, it came to the final. Bobby came from Man City.
He did.
He got us back into the game, didn't he?
He
and
did.
Then, for him to actually score the goal to get us into the penalties.
Yeah.
But it's there's tons of little stories, and the main thing is if they get the chance, let's hope they take it.
That's right. We talked a lot about the positive kind of Liverpool culture and within the youth setup academy and about that clear pathway. But you are right when you talked about Camacho, Camacho leaving. And obviously Camacho isn't the first player to leave this season, which is just something I've noticed. Mm-hmm. Obviously Edwin Taxeth has chosen not to renew his contract. A busy, bustling player in the centre of the park. He's going to go back and play in his native country.
Mm-hmm.
He's looking at probably signing a contract there. Maybe that's a domestic thing. Like anyone, a lad coming in from a different country, it's hard to settle.
Yeah.
And then obviously the lad we signed from Barcelona too, Bobby Andacanye, who was coming to great acclaim as a player, expected big things of. He's actually going to sign a pre-contract with Lazio.
He's going
into Italy to play. So that's just something to keep an eye on.
So there's people coming in, there's people going out.
Yeah, that's right. I think with Camacho, obviously the pathway into the team was at left back, but they had a bit of an outburst on the social media, on Instagram.
He did, didn't he? I believe
talking
that,
about
yeah.
he was a goal scorer and he was there to score goals, not play left back.
Well, the two games he came in, one was at right back. Was it the Wolves game, the FA Cup?
That's right, yeah.
And as I said, he just, with Trent was put in the middle. He was a centre midfielder. And then the story is he saw that he's never going to get into there. And he thought, well, let's have a go at right back. And the way he's brought himself forward and to do that.
Yeah.
So maybe things have changed. You've got to be clever. You've got to think how you can adapt yourself. And football now is gone. You're not just a right back. You can be a right winger. You can move into the centre. You can go, you've got to have that versatility in the team to play around, isn't it?
Liverpool's still showing smarts, though. At the end of the day, we sold Camacho, but we got good money for him. We got 5 million up front, 2 million add-ons, plus the sell-on clause.
Yes.
Which is 25% plus the buyback clause, which means we can buy him back if he does turn into a whale.
Martin Edwards now, he's not letting nobody go on the cheap, and he's not letting, if they do go, he's going to make sure that if they go on and they fulfil the potential, that we do get some of that.
Yeah.
So that's cool.
Statue to Edwards.
He's doing the job behind the scenes. Yeah. As I said, we're not hearing anything.
Yeah.
A lot of the papers are throwing stuff out left, right, and centre, but we're not hearing anything contract.
Yeah.
And until you see them holding that shirt, like set last week,
yeah,
they're not a Liverpool player till then.
Yeah, and I think the last one I'll touch on, and obviously such a young boy who was thrust into the first team, was obviously Kiana Huber.
Mm-hmm.
Kiana's obviously someone who was signed to little fanfare, but at the time it was let it be known when he was brought in that we've got a player here. We've got a boy who's going to make a big difference and going to be part. I can play it right back, can play it centre back.
Yeah.
Hugely adaptable, and Liverpool... there's a conversation in Liverpool that Trent will eventually move into the midfield. Mm-hmm. That is something that there hopes to be a natural progression for. Yeah. So there's going to be a spot at that right back position for a player to make it their own over the coming years as Trent comes into his prime. You know, he's only 20 still at the moment in time. So big things, and there's a lot of opportunities there for players. And I think that's the key thing. It's keeping those opportunities, making those young players, those youth players who look at Liverpool and think, oh, I'll go to PSG, I can go to Manchester City, I can go to, you know, go to Juventus, I can go to there, but no, I could go there and enjoy the trappings of life, or I could go there and actually go and play for a team that wins things and gives me an opportunity.
That's the thing, they've got the, you know, he's made everyone aware that they can come through.
Yeah.
So hopefully, we'll, you know, I'd love to see that progression.
And Trent's a shining example of that.
There you go. Well, he's now at the moment, one of the last things I just picked up before we come on air, he's now rated as the third most valuable young player in the world. So, you know,
amazing, isn't
it's crazy. You got, I think the only ones in front is Mappe and De Ligt.
Two Champions League finals.
There you go, at the age of 20.
Yeah, unbelievable.
Living the dream, isn't he? Living the dream.
Played the bet against the best teams in the world, proved himself every day. And he's learning on the job. Yeah. That's what thing, you know, he's not a polished player.
He's only going to get better.
Yeah, he is. That's so exciting for us.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, everybody. I hope you've enjoyed this Youth in Focus Liverpool Academy and chat. And basically, we'll see you again soon. Thanks you very much. Up the red man.
Take it easy, guys.